First, we need to open new file in Photoshop, and we'll take the size 1280 pixel by 720 and 72 resolution. Then we'll open our artwork in Adobe Illustrator. I'm selecting the artwork and open into Adobe Illustrator. Now we'll select the artwork and make the duplicate copy of that. And then we'll select the one artwork and change into one color, black color artwork. So we'll use the recolor artwork, color recolor option, and make the black color. Now our object is black color. Go to Pathfinder and join all the small pieces and make a single object. Now our dinosaur shape is a single object. We have copied that object and paste into Photoshop. So we have adjusted the size onto our artwork, Photoshop artboard, and now this is placed. So we'll go to effect and make our object into convert smart object. So now it's a smart object. Now we'll go to blur and go to Gaussian blur and adjust the blur edge blur accordingly so that object shape will not distorted. And here I'm adjusting the blur option, and I'm taking 9.7 9.7. So this is our blur option. Again we'll go, first we need to check the our layer is selected, and we'll go to edit and open the script. Now we'll go to browse and open the folder. You will get the download link in the description. You can open the folder and select the line distorted image processor file, okay, and place open. So now that this option will open, and take the point like 7x7, so that 7 pixel by 7 pixel they can scan the image. Click OK and wait for the complete the scanning. The scanning will take some time, so just wait for the scanning. You cannot open Photoshop during this scanning process. And now our scanning is completed. Just click OK and don't close this file. Just save as this file and save the file format like Photoshop EPS file. Photoshop EPS file. So I can open this file into Illustrator. Make sure that you have not closed that Photoshop file. Now I have saved this file. Now I'm clicking on OK, and now my file is saved as a EPS. So now we'll go to Illustrator and open that EPS file into Illustrator. So I'm opening this file. Yeah, this is the file, look like this one, like this. Now we'll go to, again we need to open a script. We'll go to a script and browse other script. Here is a script. Again you have to open the line distorted folder and select the line distorted JSX file. Okay, now this file is open. So you will after clicking open, this window will pop up and we have to adjust the height and the angles. So now this vector file is ready. So click OK, and this automatically completing this process. Illustrator automatically that simplify your object. So now they simplify the lines and deleted the extra anchor point. So I have selected this thing and make a side of artwork. I will repeat this option for your easy understanding. You can check it again. So I'm repeating it again. Here I'm trying with a different height and different angle. Now the effect. So you can check the effect, how the effect will change. So I'm making the height 1 and change the angle into 90 degree. So I'm clicking OK. So you can easily compare how the both files are a curve and their height will be different. So you can check the closed look of that. Yeah, I'm placing side by side of both the artwork. Now you can compare how the height, if you're changing the height and angles, how the artwork will be changed. So you can explore the things on your own, and you can check that and number of things. Even you can use a single file, single Photoshop EPS file, and make the different angles and height. You don't need to make a different file for that. So now I'm selecting this file and I'm separating both the file, like line and their background. Yeah, you can see that all the lines are different, like separated. So I have selected the line part and this is the line part. Yeah, I make a different, like separate that both the file and select the line one. I just wanted to make the line little thicker, so I have selected the line file and go to a stroke. I am changed the stroke. Now it's too, it's little, I need a little more thick, so I have changed it to 3. I'm checking this thing. Now we'll change it to 3. So now it's looking yeah, it's little thick now. So now this looking nice, lines are thick. Now I'll go to my dyno artwork. I need to copy my original dyno, so I'll go to the dyno artwork. I just copy this artwork. Yeah, I have copied that artwork and selected this line. Just select all the lines. Yeah, selected this line, go to object and expand. Yeah, click fill. Yeah, it's expanded now. Now all the lines will convert it into object. Okay, so just see, yeah, all the lines are object now. So just now paste that dinosaur artwork on the top of that object, because my all line strokes are converted into object now. So I pasted that top of that. You can use the anchor point and adjust the dino size. Yeah, now it's looking good. Here's something I need to check. Yeah, some little I need to adjust manually. You can adjust this thing. Yes, it's adjusted now. So again I have to copy. Now my dinos are placed perfectly. So now I'm making the copy that dino and make a new layer. Yeah, I'm making a new layer and go to edit and paste in place. So I have one more copy of dino in the top of the layer, one extra. If I am hiding this dino, now again select that line background parallel lines. I have selected that and copy this thing. So your alternate option for copy, you can go to object and select copy. Yeah, this is the option. You can copy it from there. Now again paste in place. So again I'm pasting. Yeah, again paste in place. So I have a two copy of line in that, one top and one is on the bottom. So select again, select this lines and go to object and go to compound path and just make a compound path. So our top lines are compound path. Now select the top lines and the dino object dino and go to right click and make a clipping mask. This option will open and click yes, so that dino will convert into line object and thus effect will be come. So now dino is ready and background is there. And now I'm little personally touching my artwork. You can check the close look of that. Hope you have liked this video. If you have any doubt or any question, just comment in the comment box. All the required files and scripts download links are in the description. You can download all the files are free and it's you can click on the links and you can download this file and use. Also, if you have any if you want any detailed video or any topic, or if you want to explore anything, just comment. I will make this video. Thank you so much for watching.